Hello friends, I am Khurshid Alam, Editor-in-Chief with Contemporary Literary Review India, a leading literary journal in English literature. In this video, I am going to show you how to prepare research papers. If you are working in the academic field, be it humanities, social sciences, pure sciences, medicines, or technologies, you have to write research papers on a regular basis. This training will help you to prepare research papers in any discipline. Today, we will discuss how to write better titles, how to format research papers, how to write abstract and keywords, how to use citation and references, and at the end, we will see a dummy sample of research paper. Formatting and title. Regarding formatting, you should first check the submission guidelines of the journal where you want to submit your paper. If there is no written guideline, then use Times New Roman or Arial font type between 12 to 14 size. Regarding title, write a meaningful title. Your title should be central to the topic of your research paper. It should not be too long or too short. Then mention the names of authors. If you have multiple authors, then mention all of them. Mention that author first who wants to communicate to the journal. Then mention the affiliation. For example, if you are working with any department, then mention the name of the department followed by the university or academic institution. Abstract. Abstract is a very important part of your research paper. Generally, most of the writers copy first few paragraphs from the research paper and use them as abstract. This is not the right way. Write an original abstract for your topic. Abstract is required for two important reasons: to attract readers and for indexing. When any reader goes to search for any material for their study, they type keywords on any standard search engines. These search engines bring up the result on the basis of first few words from your research paper. If you have better abstract, then it is more likely that your article will appear on the first best top results. Indexing. Nowadays, most of the journals index their materials with online libraries and journal directories. They archive their materials based on category of the topic and abstract of your article. So the abstract will help them to archive the articles in their database. To understand more about abstract, you can visit this website that I have cited here, that is writingcenter.unc.edu/handouts/abstracts. Keywords. Use at least 5 to 6 keywords in the research paper. 7 to 8 keywords would also be okay. One keyword generally should not be longer than 4 to 5 words, unless it is a combination of globally known terms. Avoid using abbreviation and plural forms in keywords. Main body. Divide your paper in 4 to 5 sections. Give a heading to each section. It would be better if you have an introduction in the beginning of the paper main body and a conclusion at the end of the paper. Citation and references. If you write a paper without any proper citation, your paper would be merely an essay. It would not be a research article. To convert this into a research article, you have to use in-text citation, endnote, and footnote in ample numbers. Citation is in addition to bibliography that you use in your research paper. By copyright laws, any author or research scholars can quote from any available materials they base their subject on freely without asking for the permission from authors or publishers. Citation is required for many reasons. It shows that you have done research thoroughly. It shows that you have given due credit to previous researchers and scholars. It also helps you to avoid plagiarism in your paper. That helps to make your paper original. To help readers to base their materials or research materials in future studies. Whenever you borrow anything like ideas, words, phrases, figures, images, tables, graphs, estimations, facts, findings from any source, you have to mention the source. Obviously, while doing research, you might have studied lots of articles, journals, magazines, and books. Mention all the sources you have studied for your research paper. In short, the elements in citation should include authors' names, titles of articles, journals, magazines, books, publication date, page numbers, issue numbers, and volume if you have. This is one of the best examples of quotation, that if you are quoting, then write the sentences and then give the citation. That is Wikipedia here. Importantly, I have mentioned one tool here, Zotero. This is a free and open source tool. You can use this tool for creating bibliography. Reference style guide. Your references or bibliography should be based on certain style guides. Some of the popular style guides are MLA, that is Modern Language Association, APA, that is American Psychological Association, ACS, American Chemical Society, and IEEE. Any research papers in humanities should be based on MLA style guide. In science, they should be based on APA or Chicago style guide. In electronics or robotics, they should be based on IEEE. Now, we have reached to the conclusion that what should be the final structure of your paper. Your paper should have title, author name, affiliation, abstract, keywords, main body, and references. Here is the dummy of the paper. That is, here I have mentioned the title of the paper, followed by author, affiliation, then comes abstract, then keywords, then section of the body, and references. Thank you.